last presentation is indomethacin prophylaxis after the trial of indomethacin prophylaxis in the preterm infant, a post-trial field evaluation by propensity score is going to be given by Dr. Ali Al-Mudir. Dr. Ali Al-Mudir is a consultant neonatologist in King Fahad Hospital, Jizan.
Assalamu alaikum. Thanks for the Saudi Neonatal Society giving me this opportunity to share this abstract, which I did it with my team 18 months back when I was doing my fellowship with my colleagues at Dalhousie University in Halifax in Nova Scotia in Canada. So our abstract title was about indomethacin prophylaxis after the TIP trial, which is post-trial field evaluation by propensity score. So just a little bit background about the ductus arteriosus, which is important structure in the fetal life. And we know that at birth, closure of the ductus arteriosus is essential part of postnatal adaptation. In preterm infants, failure of ductus arteriosus closure after birth can be associated with some increased incidence of some complication as mentioned in the literature, like chronic lung disease, intraventricular hemorrhage, and necrotizing enterocolitis. So clinician may choose to treat PDA, attempting to minimize the risk of these complications. So we start our thinking doing this study after we observed that physician in our units and decided about application of TIP trial depending on their main interest of the result of the TIP trial study. So there was two areas of the, just to remind you about the TIP trial results. So there was reduced short-term adverse outcome PDA with odds ratio of 0.3 and reduce severe periventricular or intraventricular hemorrhage with odds ratio of 0.6. In the other side, the primary outcome and the main interest of the TIP trial was showing no difference for the death or disability at 18 months. And the effects of indomethacin prophylaxis on the long-term neurodevelopmental remain uncertain. So our objective from the study was to determine the effect of indomethacin prophylaxis for the infants less or equal 29 weeks gestation, and the location was by physician preference. And our primary outcome was death or adverse neurodevelopmental outcome, and we used the gross motor function classification system. And we defined either one of the five cerebral palsy or severe cognitive delay using actual MDI or severe hearing loss or bilateral blindness. So the method we use is a retrospective study, and we include all the preterm less than or equal 29 weeks gestational who had received prophylaxis indomethacin and compared to those who had not received it. And the study groups were developed by searching the perinatal follow-up program database of babies born in Nova Scotia between January 2005 and June 2012, and we applied a propensity score matching system obtaining from the logistic regression analysis of factor that best predicted the treatment with indomethacin. So apply 2-to-1 matching strategy, and it was attempted to each treated baby with matching 2 to untreated babies. So the result, so the group was compared in their rate of IVH, ROP, failure to thrive, deafness, blindness, and all form of cerebral palsy, PDA, and composite measure of death or disability within 1 year. And we end with 94 babies in treated group and 169 babies in untreated group. So this is the main result. And if you can see, we didn't have any difference in IVH. So 34% received indomethacin and compared to 37%, not significantly significant. So all the thing we look at was not really significant, except the ROP, which we have 67% on babies receive indomethacin compared to 48% who didn't receive, and it was statistically significant, 0.004. And the other things was the PDA. We have 22 on the babies who receive indomethacin compared to 75, and it gave a p-value of 0.001. So the only statistically significant, as I said, were regard the ROP, where the rates was significantly higher in the baby who treated with indomethacin, and these things was little bit concern on the previous TIP trial, but it was not statistically significant. And the other thing, as I mentioned, the symptomatic PDA was where treated babies have lower rate in the control. So the conclusions, our data support the previous study, which showed no improvement in the rate of survival without neurosensory impairment at 18 months, although still the decrement in the symptomatic PDA rate is there. And this practice raised the concern regarding the significant higher rate of ROP in the treated group. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Al-Mudir. Now the floor for discussion. And so, question, I mean. Yeah. Any questions?
Yeah, just one
yes,
comment.
Dr. Sivan.
Thank you for a very nice presentation. I was wondering two things. And the first thing is the grading of IVH. Did you include all IVH in your outcome data or only the grade 3 and 4 ones?
We include all the IVH.
Okay. Because I think one of the major take-home messages by the TIP trial was that
the severe forms
were reduced. And my second question was the matching procedure you did. How did you do that? How did you match the non-treated infants?
So we used the propensity score. So each one treated with indomethacin matched to two with Pellens, just to overcome the covarieties. And it was done by epidemiologists.
Okay, thank you very much.
Yes, thank you, Dr.
Yes, Dr. Sajjad.
I think I have two questions. Did you evaluate periventricular leak malacia separately from IVH, or did you include it in the same group?
No, it was separate.
I see. And sorry, maybe I missed the data on that. I did not see the figures. What was the difference in the incidence of PVL in both groups? And the second question is about the what was the protocol of giving the prophylactic indomethacin? How much were you giving over how much number of days?
So we include any baby receive anything less than 0.3 milligram per kg per dose in the first 24 hours.
Okay, so you're giving 12 hourly?
Yes, 12 hourly. Yeah.
So just one comment. When we find an unexpected significant p-value, there is a post hoc power analysis called Cohen test. So you go there to see what is the power of that, because you may have a significant difference, but really the power was only 20% or 30%. So just you may go, you can find it.
Thank you.
Any questions from female side?
No questions.